the occurrence of ureterovaginal fistula formation following an abdominal hysterectomy is not an uncommon complication. Through this video, I want to share with you a fluoroscopic cystoscopic method for making a diagnosis of such a complication. First of all, you examine the urinary bladder cystoscopically thoroughly. See the area of left ureteric orifice, the pterygon of urinary bladder and bladder neck, right ureteric orifice. Spend time to see the efflux of urine coming out of each ureteric orifice. Examine right lateral wall, the posterior wall, the left lateral wall, the area of high posterior wall, and the dome of the urinary bladder. The dome can be identified by presence of air bubbles here. Next, you pass a 5 French ureteric catheter in one of the ureter, the left side here, for about a centimeter, and then inject contrast via the ureteric catheter to obtain fluoroscopic image. As you inject contrast, you will see the dilated ureter, and on injection of little more contrast, you may see some extravasation from the lower ureter. In this case, the extravasation is going towards the medial direction into one of the vaginal fornix. Next, you try to pass a straight floppy tip 0.038 inch guide wire through the area of the leakage in the ureter. You may need to make few attempts gently to pass the wire, and then the wire will bypass this area of leakage and will go up in the renal pelvis and will coil here. Then you pass the ureteric catheter over the guide wire so as to dilate any co-associated narrowing in the ureter at the site of leakage. Having done that, you can take the ureteric catheter out and then pass a 6 French double J stent over this guide wire. As you pass the stent up into the ureter, you should watch the movement of stent, the advancement of tip, both cystoscopically as well as fluoroscopically. Sometimes the upper end of stent gets coiled in the middle of the ureter. In that case, pass the wire in the stent again, let it coil well in the renal pelvis. Once you are satisfied with the positioning of upper end, withdraw the guide wire and also see the proper positioning of the lower end of DJ stent. Next, you pass the ureteric catheter on the right side, and here also inject some contrast to obtain a fluoroscopic image of the ureter. You will see a ureter which is normal. This has to be demonstrated fluoroscopically. The normal ureter shows smooth curves and it's not dilated. As you withdraw the ureteric catheter out of this orifice, whatever contrast you have filled in the ureter and renal pelvis will drain down. You can watch the ureteric jet cystoscopically and also watch the ureteric peristalsis fluoroscopically. And by observing the normal phenomena, you can be sure that there is no fistula formation on this side. So even if you demonstrate fistula in one ureter, you must demonstrate that the other ureter is normal and healthy. So in every case, please exclude a coexisting injury to one ureter and to the bladder. Thank you very much for watching this video. You can post your comments and questions to my email mentioned here.